first, I thought that it is a difficult job, and I thought maybe we cannot fulfill it, the promises which we made to the people before elections. But I would thank the department, the whole education department, the KP government, because of which we were able to achieve not 100%, but I believe almost 70 or 80% we have achieved what we wanted to, not 100%. And secondly, by the grace of God, we have been able to make substantial impact. As I mentioned earlier, more than 35,000 students have opted to shift from private sector schools to government sector schools. So that's a big achievement for us. It was the trend was otherwise. People were shifting, students were shifting to private sector schools. And the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa cabinet has approved a comprehensive legislation to ensure the right to free and compulsory education. I think that is a big achievement as well. We have also developed a legislation for establishment of private school regulatory authority, which is a difficult job, but we have finalized it, and hopefully in the next assembly session we will be able to pass it to the assembly. And I would definitely mention the independent monitoring unit, which we started, and which has produced excellent results, due to which the non-performing teachers or the absent teachers, which they usually complain, even now they complain, but I think it has, the independent monitoring unit has done a tremendous job, and due to that specific independent monitoring unit, the ratio or the attendance of teachers has increased. I know for the international community it is a maybe they won't understand, because in many developed countries, nobody can imagine that a teacher has drawn salary and not visiting his school. So I think that's the, not problem of international community, but in Pakistan it was a huge problem, and alhamdulillah we have been able to achieve that. Regarding basic missing facilities, we have allocated almost 21 billion rupees. That is historic milestone which we have achieved, because no government earlier had allocated this much amount to basic missing facilities. So 21 billion rupees is a big amount. And we have been able to provide 1.4 million chairs or furniture to kids. 2.1 million were without even a chair. So we managed to provide 1.4 million, and the rest 0.7 million will be provided in the next budget, inshallah. We have established 1,340 IT labs and 110 interactive whiteboards. And we are developing blended learning approaches to make full use of these facilities. That is, I think, a new concept in government sector school. So, finally, in a matter of, it is a matter of pride for a province that Khyber Pakhtunkhwa cabinet has already approved the needed financing for the education sector plan. For the current fiscal year, the government of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa has allocated 118 billion for the education sector. And the cabinet has also approved a budget of 139 billion, which is a phenomenal increase. The last ANP government, the last budget of theirs was 61 billion. So an increase from 61 billion for this year, 118 billion. Almost, I think, 93-94% increase, and for the next budget, it will be increased to 138 billion, hopefully, inshallah. And in the end, I would thank the international community, the development partners, all the provincial government, the education department, and especially one person I would like to mention here is Mr. Abdul Latif. I know he's a backbencher and usually media shy. If he's here, if he can please stand up. not here? He was here, but I think he's he will be out for smoking. Normally he does. So whole of the department did a wonderful job. I know, I confess that we have not been able to achieve 100%, and we would like to achieve 100%, but as you know, it was a difficult job for the department and myself. I tried my best, and inshallah, almost 12 months are remaining, so we would like to fulfill what we have not fulfilled yet. And the next maybe 20-30%, which is remaining, we will do that in the next, in the coming government after winning the next election, inshallah. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Honorable Minister. It's always heartening to listen to you, Minister, the man charged with vision of change, did unfold his vision.